Unlucky. All right, let's go watch lane phase. How did we lose the 2v2? How did we lose? This guy literally took like the worst bases of all, like the all time. He missed like literally so many creeps. Champ, like, really picky. Like he's half HP, right? Lux has no abilities. Was I right? Yeah, I got ignited and then Yumi pressed E heal. So literally I got healed for nothing. We ignited the fucking Lux. Oh, that's how we lost. Cause this Yumi literally fucked up everything that she possibly could. There was legitimately nothing that she could have done worse, actually, I don't think. Cause like auto, exhaust, Q, I get ignited. That's her E. That's heal. And then I can't fucking do anything else. Well, are you good? Draven was dead. To your auto? Okay, I don't see your auto. Like, I flash to secure it, because I don't see the auto. Because I would rather ensure that this guy dies instead of him getting the stacks first. But regardless, this should be a clean 2-0 wipe. Like, 100%. Passive auto. Okay, sure. But how the hell, like, do I expect you to passive auto to kill this guy? Like, that is one thing that could cause Draven to die, and maybe I live. But if we look at everything else, let's look at everything else, right? Okay. We heal one singular auto. We press E on one auto, so I have to like wait a little bit. Lux misses everything. Exhaust. I get ignited. We don't heal right here when I know that I'm going to fight because I'm dashing in and I burn my exhaust. Your E heal does nothing because I'm already ignited. You don't hop out until the very last auto. So you're going to tell me that the reason we lost this, or the reason this didn't go as well as it should have, was because I did not predict that your auto would kill here, is what I'm hearing. That is your argument. Instead of thinking you fucked up four different clicks that could have made this happen. I still had three pots. Okay, sure. Three pots, three biscuits. Sure. So I can burn a pot here. Okay. I'm still half HP. If I burned a pot, because I'm not burning a pot when I'm like full HP, right? There's no reason to burn a pot here. When do I burn a pot? Do I burn a pot after one auto? Does anyone burn a pot after one auto? No. You can't argue to me that's actually factual, because you're just dumb if you just want to get now. Maybe when you go in. Okay, so I go in here, I can pop a pot. So in the course, Let's look at this. Let's just go through this entire thing as a whole, okay? So, this is 15 seconds. 15 seconds for me to get the full value out of a health pot. I can burn it here now. So, if I want to get the full value out of my health pot, and let's go with cookies too. Let's go with cookies. Cookies don't... They get stronger as you're weaker, right? So if I pop them all when I'm full HP, I don't get any value out of them. So let's say, so it's going to be 745 for me to get a full value out of all my pots. And this is going to be after, this is while I'm ignited too. So I lose healing from the pot as well. So you're telling me that it is not the fact that your heal and your E and heal is late that does not cause the loss of this 2v2. You're going to convince me that your auto and my pot usage is going to be the rain is going to be the reason we lost this. You cannot be a real human being if you are actually trying to argue the stance. Like, the correct thing to do here is just type my bad and that's it. I fought in his wave. There's two creeps. You are literally grasping for straws. You are unironically grasping for straws. You could have hopped out after you healed me and ignite and just auto. You could have healed me, E'd, and then hopped out to auto. The entire time, like after this, when Draven has nothing else, you could have hopped out. You are unironically grasping for straws, so you do not take responsibility and accountability for the fact that this 2v2 went wrong. Please understand that. It's just support gap then. Yeah, you just type my bad and then we move on. Like, that's it. Like, after that, the discussion's over. Because I have literally defeated every possible counter argument, even when they're like negative percent chance of it actually mattering for this to be real. Like, at most, the one thing I'll admit is, like, I can still die regardless, the one for one, but at least we get the Draven kill, and, like, maybe I live. That's it. IDK, man, just unlucky. It is not unlucky. It is just the Yumi player is bad, and that is it. There is nothing else you can say other than a MB didn't press heal, didn't press E in time, and didn't hop off in time, and we also pressed E after taking a singular auto. When, in this case, Yumi E gives fucking... Actually, did Yumi E give attack speed? It does give attack speed. I was right. So, in the world where I could have this E as I'm going in right now to get the bonus attack speed and have the heal and get summoner heal... to have the most amount of value healing before this ignite, we think that the Lucian misplayed this 2v2. And I'm not challenging anything, but I'm pretty sure Draven shits on Lucian. So we're gonna tell me that a half HP Draven is allowed to fully shit on a Lucian. Again, you are, like, I don't know if, like, you just hate me or something, or you're just trying to find any fucking room of error to make some form of valuable argument, but it is quite literally, like, not a thing. And I got E. ...75 physical damage at rank 1. You're telling me 75 damage is what costed this 2v2. Just look up the matchup. I've played this matchup. I've literally have diffused every argument that you have tried to bring up. The wave, 2CS. The auto, no one expects that. The pot, it's not even 745. Literally... Lux has no abilities. It's just her ignite and her auto attack and maybe E. There is quite literally nothing that is able to be used in anything that you have wrote so far in my chat that makes it seem like it is not my fault. I mean, dude, ignite is just OP. Guys, I don't want to be the asshole streamer, but I'm just going to headshot this. I don't want to be the asshole streamer that just means, like, anytime someone tries to, like, tell me that I'm wrong, just to, like, argue with me, to argue, but I'm just gonna do it, because that legit gave me, an actual tumor. Like, every single argument that was presented in front of me, I broke down, and I explained it perfectly, and this person just goes all the way to unlucky. Nice, man. Nice. On today's episode of Dumb and Dumber, we have a special contestant. Like, it's unlucky if Draven had a 1% crit rune. If Draven had a 1% crit rune and he crit me, that's fucking unlucky. Yeah, I can accept that one. But when we can, like, actually just misplay everything we legitimately could have and chalk it up to unlucky, nah, get the fuck out of here, kid. I'm gonna try to understand from both sides. What's the chat? Sorry. But it would have been optimal. Well, let me see this. So it would have been optimal for her to heal at 50%. So how 2v2s and like how fighting works in bot lane, considering that bot lane is the only lane that usually takes summoner heal. The moment you get into an all-in fight that you think is going to happen, like it's going to turn into an all-in, you press the heal button. Like, even if it's like above 50% HP, even if it's like 80% HP, it's better because you're trying to get the most value out of this summoner before the ignite hits, and it cuts down the healing. Like, right here, hold on. Here, when I exhaust and I take this auto, summoner heal, let's go. Let's do everything. Summoner heal. Summoner heal at base. Let's go, what were we, like level 5? It heals around 150 to about 136 or some shit like that. What is this? Effectiveness comparison. Yeah. Basically, it heals like 150 HP. So, I'm already at 600 out of 900 HP. Oh, my bad. So, this is a chart, right? This is how much healing you get as it scales up per level. So, it does 136 to 150 right now. Or maybe 120. Regardless, it's around that 130 range to just give an average median. I'm already at 600 HP. The fight has started, so we throw it up on you ASAP so it can be back up ASAP? No, we're talking about a Yumi E, not... That's different from Summoner Heal. I was really hoping, thank you for ganking me. I enjoyed watching that guy be completely delusional. Yeah, fucking content. Like, what about the support matchup? The support matchup is this. You want to see the support matchup? So, Lux is a standard champion in League of Legends. She has 4 abilities. Until level 6, she has 3 abilities, actually. So let's count. 1 ability missed, no damage. 2 ability missed, no damage. That is why I was prompted to go all in here. Because this guy's half HP. I pretty much have all my abilities coming up. I just auto-queue this guy and exhaust him. Where's her shield? She doesn't even have ability number 3. Like, it's actually so fucked. So that's the support matchup. The support matchup is fucking whiff number 1, whiff number 2, and then, like, it just doesn't heal me in time. Like, I don't understand how this works. Minotaur style, I haven't played in so long, this is embarrassing. Oh, are you the Lux? Yo, were you listening to that entire argument? Please confirm with me that my Yumi is a bit fucked in the head. Like, my god. I don't even know if that person was the actual Yumi player, or like just someone that wanted to defend and just make me seem wrong. But Jesus Christ, that was absolutely fucking retarded.
Aw, damn.
But Lux can auto, can't she? Why can't Yumi auto? You're telling me that a Yumi that has an E that should be a heal, a Q that can be a damage tool, 2 offensive summoners where she has heal and ignite, where she could use it before. So let's look at this. She healed too late, she healed post-ignite, so I get reduced healing, and then ignited the Lux. Now I think I understand. Yes. TLDR, this is the most fucking despicable fucking League player right here, in terms of this 2v2. And then we go, you still died. How? I think I can go back in time. If we go back around like 16 years when your parents fucking post-coitus, like pre-coitus, I think we might have been able to find out why we lost that one. But that's just me. Wow, that was an interesting conversation. I haven't spoken to someone as dumb as that in a while. Like, you have to have talent to be that fucking dumb. Like,
if you go to a talent show
and your talent is having the least amount of brain cells in your fucking graduating class, you might win. You might have a chance. Like, actually, you might have a chance. The Mido, it's a counter matchup. Oh yeah, it's a counter matchup when Lux misses everything and they're fucking Draven with half HP. My fault. Oh, my bad. I also fought in their wave, you know, the 2CS. Would you rather take Exhaust over Cleanse that game? No, Exhaust is better that game. Because what they have is a Kane, they have a GP, and they have this person. The only thing I can cleanse is a Teemo Blind and a Lux Snare. That's about it. I legit think Yumi couldn't auto set Dynasty or do it. Yeah, most Yumi players are very bad. The thing about Yumi is she literally breaks the game because you require literally negative fundamentals. Because you become invulnerable from going inside someone. You have a constant heal. You have a CC. You have a very pretty damage poke. And your W applies the stats that you build onto the person you're latched onto. So quite literally, you don't need to auto. However, the Yumis that do auto tend to have a little bit more brain cells than the rest. Let's see. All right, then Ignite. Okay, cleansing Ignite is not a valid reason to take Cleanse. People take Cleanse, like, when they want to cleanse the Exhaust, because that is a bigger summoner spell to take off. I'm still quite told they didn't pick Nami if she was open. They can also blind pick it easily. I mean, let's do a fucking adventure, honestly. Euphoric Recall. Let's fucking go on a magic little field trip. We'll fucking just do everything at this point. I'm too pissed. So if I'm going to click on this profile, if I see Yumi as the most played champion, if I see Yumi as the most played champion, someone better drop a sub. Someone better drop a sub. Damn, I was close. So fucking close. Very, very close. Who the fuck plays Jorik in the midst of this? What the fuck? Jesus. Hold on. I have to do some research. Ah, you're just fucking dumb in the head. Hold on. Let's do some investigating on this. Let's find out. Oh, you randomly have a 7. I think I know what's going on, guys. I think I found something about the account. There appears to be another person that... Oh my god, wow. We can go from playing just a full enchanter pool, but suddenly we're just goated at Twisted Fate. We're Dopa. We're fucking Adrian Riven, and we're done. Oh, but we can't play Nami. We can't play Lulu. We're actually pretty bad at Seraphine too. Wow. We're good at top. My god, this shit's goated. Look at the previous season. I'm at 2021. Okay. We didn't have someone on our account yet. We suddenly get really good at Nidalee in fucking in 2020, eh? Oh yeah, we're fucking good at League of Legends, I promise. My fucking Lanta. Well, I'm not tilted anymore. I've come to terms with everything. BF plays on the account? Hey, Brandon, that's sexist. We would never assume that a boyfriend plays on your account and boosts this person, now would we? That's bad manner, Brandon. We don't like that kind of slander. We support women here. Who would ever let that happen? Fucking... Are you telling me you don't think a woman can play Twisted Fate and fucking Riven and Fiora at a fucking 70% win rate level after fucking doing nothing but enchanters? Is that what we've come to? That is sexism. We can't press ignite properly, but you know what? When it comes to playing top lane, hey, split pushing, easy. Irelia combos, fucking easy. TF Blade fucking stream on the second monitor. She's fucking clean, bro. Oh my fucking god. Oh shit. It is. We've discovered a gold mine of an account. Holy fuck. Just fan of champions, but you know if you're in Riven, just do brain death. Yeah, I want a challenge. I want to feel challenged. So, I can't fucking... These champions are too easy. I win on them too much. Let me play the enchanter role. Oh, fuck yourself, bro. Actually, my god. Oh, it just seems like a certain type of... No, Brandon, you don't get it. We know. Like, we're extending the joke to an extreme because this happens way too often. It happens very often. It's a literal stereotype. So, we're literally just making fun of it. Like, the moment my eyes lit up on stream, like, you guys could see it when I saw the fucking ribbon or the TF. Yo, can that be, like, clippable? Like, did my eyes, like, legitimately just open up, just go, oh, we found the fucking sauce.